this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Today, let's talk about how you do not need to use Google Play to release your Android app. So a few weeks ago, I was meeting with a potential new client about taking over their Android app. So it's a company and they have an Android application which they use Google Play to distribute, but it has a very small group of users. It's not for the general public, it's by invite only, and only certain people need to use it. Right, so we were talking about what changes need to be made to the app and what kind of problems they've had in the past. And one of the things the owner of the business has said to me was, some of their users don't want to have to set up Google accounts in order to use the app. Right? And I was like, okay, all right, cool. And you're just taking notes, you're listening to all these things. You go, oh, I see. Are you using Google accounts for authentication as an authentication mechanism? And he said, no, but they need to have a Google account in order to download it from Google Play. And I was like, oh yeah, of course. Yeah, I wasn't even thinking. Yeah, yeah. And then I thought, wait a second. You don't need to use Google Play to distribute the application, though. And he was actually surprised by that. This is one of those things where, when you get so involved in the technology and the platform, you forget what people know and don't know or what they assume. So he was surprised that you don't need to use Google Play to distribute the application. I was like, yeah, I mean, you have other platforms. You've got the Amazon App Store. You've got a bunch of other third-party app stores like SlideMe and Aptoid and GetJar. I mean, it's possible to distribute your application by not using Google Play, but Google Play just makes it easier. You just have to make sure that the users go through and select allow from unknown sources if they go to security, to settings, and then security and select unknown sources. In fact, you can have your own web page where people go through and download it. And look at China. China has loads of alternative app stores. I mean, unlike the iPhone and going through building on iOS, you don't need to go through Google in order to release your application, right? They made it open. Google's really cool that way. You need to go through the App Store if you want to release it on iOS, unless you have an enterprise distribution certificate, and they still have to go into settings and approve all that kind of stuff. You still have to go through Apple in order to get an account. But you don't with Google Play, right? And the big benefits that you get from Google Play are purchases. It's much easier to have in-app purchases because they have all that mechanism set up already. It's easier for discoverability, so people to find your application. And I know that's not a really big one because it's really hard to be found on Google Play, but just try to compare that with being found on the web. That would be much harder. It helps in terms of updates, so making sure that your updates, like when you release an update to the app, everybody gets notified of it and they can very easily go through and download it. And it's very good for security. So to make sure that it comes from the source that it is, it's signed, and it's not just a developer build distributed. But you can do that with a lot of the different app stores and you're not necessarily tied to Google Play, right? Which is really interesting. It's something that we forget about a lot because I prefer to use Google Play. I think I will continue to use Google Play because it works for me. I prefer having everything in one spot and way to do that. But it is possible if you just set up a page on the web, on the website, and people could just go through and download the application, right? The difficulty would be releasing updates and people know that the updates are available. But if you're really smart in the code, you could just put an API call or even just a file on the web, like a TXT file or a HTML file, which just has a version number on it. And when your app opens up, it checks that version number. If it's the same as the current one, fine, continue. If it's not, have a pop-up that says, there's a new version, go to this URL and download the new one. So we were talking about this kind of things, and he was really surprised about it. And I found that really interesting. On the Sensor Tower blog about 3 weeks ago, and they've been talking about this a lot, there's an article about how Google is going to miss out on $50 million this year because Fortnite is bypassing Google Play altogether in order to release their apps. I thought it was really fascinating to read about that. Fortnite is so huge, they don't need to go through Google Play. They could just bypass it altogether. They have a big enough audience that they could just send people to their site and they could just go through and download it and they could explain to them, go through the security, select unknown sources, which is actually very, very simple to do. I mean, we all do it as developers when we release a beta build to users. If you do it that way, sometimes we'll just send an APK. Other times we'll use the beta builds on Google Play, or we'll use Test Fairy as another option. But it's really interesting to see a big name like that bypassing Google Play altogether, and I wonder if it's going to confuse users at all, right? So it's something to keep in mind for those of you who do have trouble with Google Play, or you're trying to release an application. Let's say it's for your organization, and getting everyone set up with a Google account is just too difficult to do. You do not have to use Google Play in order to distribute your application. I prefer to do it. I get a healthy revenue from Google Play. We've talked about it many times before, through advertisements, through discoverability, always working on that. But it's not the only game in town, right? There are other platforms, but none of them are nearly as good, in my opinion. So let me know what you guys think. Also, what other alternative platforms to Google Play have you used? We've used Amazon, and we've used SlideMe, and we've used a few Chinese apps. Android app stores. None of them have worked nearly as well as Google Play has for me, but I'd be interested to hear what some of you guys, and we use Samsung Store, but I'd be interested to hear how some of you guys have fared with that. And that is it for today. I'll talk to you guys again tomorrow.